You can turn these to a nice colored background portraits with just a few steps using Snapseed. Basically, what I'm trying to do is take a color from the image and make it as a background for the subject, doing with the color of the shirt here. It's a bit of manual work to get the colors here, as we don't have color picker to choose colors in this app. First, I'm gonna crop the image. This should be enough, as more of the image will be covered by the color. Saving this image. Next, turning the whole image to white with curves by dragging the bottom left point of the curve towards top. Now comes the hard part to get the dark bluish color of the shirt. Check out how different colors are added with the color options in curves. Also, different colors can be created by combining these colors. To get the bluish color here, I'm going to add magenta by dragging the top point of the green curve down. Similarly, adding cyans with the red curve in combination with magenta adds blue. Dragging the RGB curve to make it more darker. Play with these till you get close to the color of the shirt. This may not be the right color, but with this step, we can always come back later to correct it. Now, using double exposure, I will add the last saved image and set the opacity to 100. Now, it's just some precise masking work needed. Revealing the added image. You can already see the colors not matching. We'll try to correct them later, but now the masking work. Zooming in as much as possible and adding back the bluish color we created by brushing carefully on the outer edges of the subject. After the masking work is completed, going back to the previous curves effect, tuning the curves to get closer to the color of the shirt. It is pretty close, so I'm gonna apply this. Adding some vignette with the vintage filter to make it more interesting. You can share this directly to Lightroom app and play with the blue hues to get different colors. Here, moving the blue hues towards purple, which I like. You can again play with the hues here to get your preferred colors. Another example, we'll work on the reddish tones here. Thank you. Again, changing the image to white with the combination of yellow and magenta, and decrease in brightness adds maroonish color here. Matching work to get the look which we need. Making the canvas a bit bigger with the expand tool. Fixing these spots by first saving the color we created. Then using double exposure to add it and brushing on those spots to fix them. Tuning the colors in Lightroom. You can add vignette here too. Hope you found some useful tips in the video. Thanks for watching.